Students, let's see how to name and draw the structures of oxy acids of phosphorus. In 12th standard textbook, we have 5 oxy acids of phosphorus. Let me list down. The first one is H3PO2, then H3PO3, then H3PO4. The next one is H4P2O6. In this case, we find 2 phosphorus atom. Again, H4P2O7. First, before moving to its structure, we must know what is the basic unit present in the oxy acids of phosphorus. It is nothing but P double bond O, single bond OH. Now, what you do is you put together all the atoms together. That is, you have one hydrogen, 1 phosphorus and 2 oxygen. So this is the basic unit what is present in the oxy acids. Now this basic unit should be subtracted from the oxy acids. So minus HPO2, minus HPO2, again minus HPO2. Whereas in the 4th oxy acid, you can see 2 phosphorus is there. So the basic unit should be multiplied with 2. So what you get is H2P2O4. This particular unit should be subtracted for the 4th one. So it is H2P2O4, again H2P2O4. Now let's see what is the residual part after subtracting from its basic units. So you have only 2 hydrogens, so it is H2. Here 2 hydrogen and 1 oxygen, so it is H2O. In this case, 2 hydrogen and 2 oxygen. Whereas here, 2 hydrogen and 2 oxygen. Whereas in the last case, 2 hydrogen and 3 oxygen is present. Now, using this clue, let me find out the structures for each and every oxy acid. The first one is H3PO2. First, let's draw the basic unit, that is P double bond O, single bond OH. And the remaining residual part is 2 hydrogens. So, let me write 2 hydrogens. So, hydrogen, bond hydrogen. The next one is H3PO3. H3PO3. For this, let me draw the basic unit, and the remaining residual part is OH2. Am I right? H2O. OH2. Okay. So OH2 means 1 OH and 1 hydrogen is there. That is OH2. The next molecule is H3PO4. First, let me draw the basic unit. This is OH and the residual part is H2O2, which indicates there are 2 OH groups. OH, OH. Okay. Next, I am coming to the next molecule. It is H4P2O6. H4P2O6. Here there are 2 phosphorus, so we have to draw 2 basic units, P double bond O OH, again P double bond O OH. The residual part is H2O2, that means there are 2 OH groups, each phosphorus carrying 1 OH, and the 2 phosphorus atoms are connected. And then comes the last oxy acid, it is H4P2O7. Here again I am drawing the 2 basic units. Here H2O3, so there is a possibility of 2 OH groups, OH, OH, and 1 more O is remaining, which connects both the phosphorus. So this is the structures of oxy acids of phosphorus. Next, we are going to see how to find out their names. For naming, you must know their oxidation number. So how to find the oxidation number? I'll tell you a short trick. Oxidation number means you have to calculate like this. 2 into number of oxygen atoms minus hydrogen atoms divided by number of phosphorus atoms. So let me again repeat. 2 into number of oxygen atoms minus number of hydrogen atoms divided by number of phosphorus atoms. Here the oxygen is 2. So 2 into 2 is 4. Hydrogen is 3. Phosphorus is 1. So the oxidation state is plus 1. In this case, the oxygen is 3. So it is 6 minus 3 by 1. So it is plus 3. Here the oxygen is 4. So 8 minus 3 by 1, which is equal to plus 5. In this case, oxygen is 6, so 12. Hydrogen is 4, whereas phosphorus is 2. So 8 by 2 is 4. Again, 7 oxygen is there. So 14 minus 4 by 2. So 10 by 2 is plus 5. So these are the oxidation states of phosphorus in the oxyacids. Now, the next one is, what you have to understand is, whenever the oxidation number is less than equal to plus 3, then you have to end the name as phosphorus acid. If the oxidation number is greater than plus 3, you have to end the name phosphoric acid. So let me apply this rule here. So these two, that is plus 1 and plus 3, the names ends with the letter by the word phosphorus acid. Again here also phosphorus acid. Okay. If it is greater than 3, how to name them? Phosphoric acid. Again, this one is also phosphoric. Again, the fifth compound is also phosphoric acid. The next clue is, let me compare plus 1 and plus 3. In this, the smaller oxidation number, here let me write, smaller oxidation number should start with the letter hypo. What is it? Hypo. And the larger oxidation number should start with ortho. And the largest, it is pyro. So in this case, you have only two oxidation states, so you have to apply these two. So plus one means you have to write smaller oxidation state. So this is known as hypophosphorus acid, whereas plus three, higher one, orthophosphorus acid. I am coming back here, these three. So the lowest oxidation number is plus 4, so I'm writing here hypo. You have to write hypo, the lower one with hypo. The other two are same. In this case, what you have to do is you check out number of phosphorus. So this has the lower phosphorus, so it must be named as ortho. So once the oxidation number is same, check out the number of phosphorus. The lower one is ortho and the higher one is pyro. So these are the names for the oxyacids of phosphorus. Next, I am coming to the concept of basicity. So these are commonly asked question in any competitive exam. In H3PO2, how to find, I'll tell you. You have to find out number of ionizable hydrogen. So where this ionizable hydrogen will be there, it will be in the OH group. In the OH, H is said to be the ionizable hydrogen. So the number of OH group will give you the basicity. Here you have only one, so the basicity is 1, or you term as monoprotic. The next one, there are two OH groups, so this is, the basicity is 2. This is diprotic. The next one, the basicity is 3, and it is triprotic. tick. Understood. And this one is 4 tetraprotic. This is TR4. Next thing what you have to know is reducing property. Which oxy acid has the reducing property? Here there is a clue to find out the reducing property. It is nothing but whenever there is a free hydrogen attached to phosphorus, then that particular oxy acid will have the reducing property. As the number of pH bond increases, the reducing property also increases. Let me come to the first oxy acid. There are 2 free hydrogens. So this oxy acid has reducing property. Coming back to the next one, here I have 1 free hydrogen. So this molecule will also has reducing property. Whereas the other 3, you don't have any free hydrogen, so they don't exhibit reducing property. Hope I think so, students, you can understand the oxy acids of phosphorus, how to name them and how to draw them, and how to find out the basicity and how to find out which one has the reducing property. Thank you, students.